Hello, Westport. My name is Colton, and as always, you're watching The Report. The date is already March 1st, which brings up the question, how is time flying by so quickly? Well, seniors, make sure you're preparing yourself for graduation, as your time's coming up fast. All students also make sure your grades are good. Tutoring is now an option, not only at school, but virtually. That's right, you're able to get help for your classes outside of school anytime. So if you're interested, go to your MCPS desktop and click that little pink, click virtual tutoring button. That simple. The Spring Into Reading Challenge is just kicking off. Westport has teamed up with the Marion Education Association to host a challenge for a Barnes and Noble gift card. A Barnes and Noble gift card for you and your first period teacher. For more information, stop by the Media Center. In other news, tomorrow, March 2nd, marks the end date for the track fundraiser it's been hosting for quite a while. So if you haven't yet, check out their lineup of shoes and slides, just in time for spring break. Speaking about making money, the Mecca Art Auction is going on now until the 17th. So if you walk down the art hallway, you've seen there's plenty of beautiful pieces, and also you've probably seen QR codes around campus. So click the QR code on screen to start bidding.
So it's basically just all the seniors in art and photography coming together to celebrate graduation and the kind of completion of our portfolios.
It will be held at the Marion Cultural Alliance downtown starting at 6, running all the way to 9. But the gallery will also be open all through March for you to come and see the art if you can't make it opening night.
It takes place on First Friday Art Walk, so you'll be able to look at other art downtown as well. Every individual senior has basically a different inquiry or like topic that they're going off of, so every individual artist will have different things like with art and photography, so you can ask the artist what their portfolio is basically about.
We will also have lots of photography work hung up from Ms. Roblin's class all over the gallery, as well as our paintings.
There will be refreshments there, so you can come and get some food.
Food and drink. Yeah. And fun. Lots and of fun.
Art kids, I guess.
Before we leap too far from art, there's a senior art showcase depicting what could possibly be the four-year love and passion onto a canvas. The opening reception is tonight from 6 to 9 p.m. at MCA 223rd Southwest Broadway Street. Pieces will be on display throughout the month of March.
Have you ever been to a football game and seen this band during halftime? Maybe you have seen these cool dancers with their flags and rifles. This is Color Guard.
Guard, to me, is basically, it's an art form. We bring the sort of enthusiasm to the marching band shows and the halftime shows because it's sort of an auditory and visual art form. So we bring the sort of visual aspect to it.
It's like interpretive dance, but with like flags, rifles, sabers. It's a lot of like, that's what we call our equipment. It's just a lot of like interpreting like music, figuring out what goes where, and all this like artistic kind of flag work.
Fun. Camaraderie, teamwork, hard work, sweat, tears, reward.
Despite what it looks like, it's a very difficult sport, and I feel like people go in without knowing that, and once they start doing it and it gets hard, they quit immediately. So if you do want to join Color Guard, just know it's a very difficult sport.
It's hard work, but the payoff is great. It's once you see, like once you get out there and you perform and you're like, wow, we did that like together, it's really is a great feeling.
It hurts. You definitely have to be careful. Broken fingers, split toes, concussions, knots. You do have to practice and you do have to stay in your toaster.
It's really great. It's really like a family. You get really close with everybody. Like you're spending so much time together, like it's hard not to get to know everyone. So it's very welcoming and friendly environment.
The reward is seeing them achieve And a lot of times people think I'm like, oh, she's abrasive and she's hard. No, because I know you're really good. Don't play with me. I know that you have it in you. Come on, let's work together and get it about you.
They also have an Instagram page. Going to Westport Color Guard on Instagram will take you where you need to go. That's WESTPORTCOLLORGUARD.
It's that time of year where my AP research students are seeking participants in their research studies. If an AP research student approaches you about asking students to complete surveys, tests, experiments, and so on, one student that could use your help is Christopher Manzer, who is studying the effects of Siberia High School on students. In other news, a Smash tournament took place recently at the gaming club. On to a video about that.
Hello Westport, my name is Edward Flanagan, and this past month, Gaming Club has been doing a Smash Bros. Ultimate Tournament. It started February 2nd, and this past Tuesday it was finished with finals and the winner being Carter Williams. Along with bragging rights, he got a $25 GameStop gift card. And with more information, here's our Gaming Club Vice President, Aiden Costas.
Hello.
Alright Aiden, tell us, how did the tournament get started?
It kind of started off with just like ideas. We were just popping in ideas here and there of like what we want to do to like bring more people into the gaming club, or just like just get something where people would be ecstatic, you know, just excited to be a part of this club, you know. So I started pinning off because we had this idea before, but we just jotted it down and just left it. So I tried bringing it back up more times, and then we started opening up to it more as we started to move on. And so, yeah.
How did the tournament go? Was it success?
I would say it was a pretty big success. It actually went pretty smooth, and you know, it was actually really nice. We set it up. I had the treasury set up, you know, the brackets so that who went against who and how we did it. So there was a fight between two people, A half, and a fight between two people, B half. And that happened every day until we got to the final bracket. And you know, it was just a really fun experience.
Are you going to be hosting any future tournaments? And if so, does someone need to be a part of the gaming club to join?
Well, of course we're gonna keep doing tournaments, because I speak for everybody in the gaming club staff when I say that it was actually a really fun experience. Even though us staff were not allowed to partake in the tournament since we made it, but it was just fun watching how just this little thing we were able to do brought so much joy to a bunch of people. And so, well, and to answer your next question, no, you do not have to be in the gaming club to join these tournaments. Last time I checked, but you know, it might be a like first come, first serve thing. If not, then it would probably be like joining the club would probably be like extra insurance to like, you know, make sure you have a spot.
Thanks, Aiden.
No problem.
Remember, if you're interested in joining the gaming club or any tournaments, you can always visit Aiden and Miss Lauer in room 240 on Tuesdays, Alpha B. Thank you, and have a great day, Westport.
Thank you to the gaming club. Well, that's all we have today, Westport. We are prompt, prepared, polite, and productive. We are Westport.